Jack Hidary is the CEO of Sandbox AQ, taking time out of his busy schedule here in San Francisco to sit down with us, coincide with RSAC. Jack, great to have you, my man.
JD, great to be here.
You just raised a new round with some top strategic investors. Congratulations on that, first and foremost. Talk to me about what that tells you about where the current space of artificial intelligence is.
Well, JD, it's great to see this level, this quality of investor attracted to our company and to the space in general. We raised $450 million in this round. This round included re-ups from investors such as T. Rowe Price and Eric Schmidt and Jim Breyer and Thomas Tull and so many other wonderful investors from the first round that we did, but also added to it Google and Nvidia as investors as well. And it's great to have those folks as validation, but also as great partners in our company.
Yeah, that's pretty cool to have some heavy hitter names like that that you can roll off there in terms of success for you and your company.
But it's also the practical things we can do day to day to bring AI to the next level. That builds on the first round we did, and so combined now we've raised $950 million, about $1 billion now, to scale this new wave of AI. And this new wave of AI, JD, is really about taking AI into the real world and high impact world. And so that means that, for example, new pharmaceuticals, new therapeutics, right? We wanna have new medicines for cancer, for Alzheimer's, for dementia, things that have stymied the biopharma industry for 40, 50 years. We can now start to attack with this new kind of AI. That AI, JD, is not large language models, not models trained on social media and cat pictures, as much as fun as those are, but this is new AI trained on the biology, the physics, the chemistry, the understanding of the engineering of the world around us. These large quantitative models, LQMs instead of LLMs, that's what's starting to have big impact. And it's great to see both the financial investors back us, but also these strategics as well.
I'm glad you mentioned the difference, and let me drill down that a little bit more, because Jack, as you know as well as anyone, artificial intelligence, it's on the tip of everyone's tongues, especially here at this conference in San Francisco. So what should the average viewer who's watching this interview know about the key differences between traditional large language models, the chatbots we're all familiar with engaging with, and what you at Sandbox AQ, what you're really pioneering and leading the way for LQMs?
Yeah, we're the global pace setter in these LQMs, JD, because the market is so large and the impact so big that we can have. In fact, 80% of the GDP of the world, 80% of the GDP of the United States, of the world, is focused on quantitative relationships. If you want a new drug, new diagnostic, you're gonna need an LQM. If you want a new material to build a car in Detroit, and you wanna lightweight that car so that it has more fuel efficiency, it's cheaper to make, then again, you need an LQM, something that is built and understands the engineering of that car. You don't want hallucinations when it comes to the operating room or the automotive factory. When we think about finance itself, New York Stock Exchange, think about all the financial institutions, the heart of finance is numbers, is equations. And so in portfolio management, in risk management, in portfolio optimization, all these areas require quantitative AI models. Not so much language models, but quantitative models. So again, LLMs, great applications across the board. You can summarize documents in the context of public companies. We're talking about here at the NYSE. You can monitor for S1s, new filings of IPOs, 10Ks, 10Qs. Great work for LLMs. But the beating heart of Wall Street is ultimately financial calculations, is numbers, is equations. And so when we think about a Sharpe ratio of how much reward are we gonna get per unit of risk, and we wanna build a portfolio to that, that requires quantitative AI to make that work. So Sandbox AQ, we're the global pace setters of this area because we wanna have this deep impact at scale. That's our motto, that's our mission, JD. Deep impact at scale, meaning that we're going for global penetration, global presence, because our customers demand that. Right, our customers are the largest banks in the world, largest pharma companies in the world, automakers and airline makers. These are the companies that we're helping with LQMs.
Jack, here at RSAC here in San Francisco, it's all about cybersecurity. These are critical systems that are so crucial to every imaginable institution. How do you see the LQMs that you are pioneering as a unique fit to the cybersecurity challenges of the moment? And there are a lot of those challenges.
Yeah, this is a very timely question. Timely because RSA is right now happening here in San Francisco, but also because the cyber threats have never been bigger in our world. AI is a wonderful, positive benefit to humanity, but also it's the dream tool of hackers. Hackers are using AI every day to do spear phishing. More and more notes getting into your email that seem very customized to you, JD, and say, hey, JD, click on this link, right? And you really want to click on that link because the letter is so custom to your needs and your ideas. In fact, they do ensnare a lot of people to click on that link and give up the credentials of their company. So it's more important than ever that we also have AI-driven cyber protection. And so that's what SandboxAQ just is announcing right now at this conference, is a new product called AQtive Guard. AQtive Guard, A-Q-T-I-V-E, Guard, AQtive Guard, you can see it at activeguard.com, is a new brand, a new kind of cybersecurity protection, mainly for companies and ultimately for the individuals in those companies. And the goal is really to protect the data that we hold dear, the data in hospitals. Mount Sinai Hospital, an example of a customer there, the data in our large corporations to make sure that we can protect that intellectual property, that IP that is so critical to American innovation. So AQtive Guard just launching right now in GA in general availability, already being tested by dozens and dozens of the best companies in the world for the past 3 years. We're finally now able to say, this is ready for scale, this is ready for the wide market now. So a very exciting moment for AI, both on the positive use side for humanity, for new drugs, new therapeutics, but also to protect us from the hackers using AI itself.
What are some of the newer and innovative ways that you and the team at SandboxAQ are bringing together AI and quantum?
Well, AI and quantum really are two of the twin engines that will drive innovation for the next 10, 20 years. This will change the face of everything that we have in our economy. And when we think about, for example, quantum, people often think about quantum computing, JD, but there's more to quantum than just quantum computing. An example of that is quantum sensors. These are sensors that take us way beyond what we could do with our traditional sensors. I'll give you a real-world example. Let's say you're flying in a plane, and obviously you want to keep that plane safe and on course, but let's say you lose GPS. Now, it's one thing to lose GPS as you're walking down the street or driving a car. We can kind of pretty much get a sense of maybe where we're at. But if you're flying a plane at 500-600 miles an hour, that is a life-threatening situation to lose GPS. Right now, there's no good solution, no really good backup to that, other than some gyroscopes, which get really out of sync within 5 or 10 minutes. And so we at SandboxAQ developed a whole new technology. An AI that reads a quantum sensor, and that quantum sensor is reading the magnetic field of our Earth. And you might say, where do we get this idea from that you can navigate with the magnetic field of the Earth? Well, it turns out about half the animal population in the world knows how to navigate with the magnetic field. Birds are migrating thousands of kilometers every single year, of course, north to south, south to north. And they're using the magnetic field of the Earth to make that happen. Whales are doing that in the sea. Turtles, many, many other animals are able to do this. Now, for the first time, humans can do it as well with the SandboxAQ technology. We've been testing this with the Air Force and with Airbus and Boeing and others. And now it's ready to start rolling out into the world. So that's an example, JD, of taking a quantum technology, a sensor that can pick up the Earth's very weak magnetic field that changes from spot to spot. Every square meter on our Earth has a unique magnetic signature, just like our fingerprints. And that fingerprint becomes a way to navigate around the world with no GPS, with no satellites. You can't jam it because it's a box on that plane that is not connected to anything out there, not connected to the internet. So that becomes an example of how AI and quantum, AQ, that's what we called our company, SandboxAQ, the A for AI, the Q for quantum, coming together to revolutionize how we can fly planes, how we can pilot ships, and ultimately how we navigate around our world.
Finally, Jack, while I still have you here for another minute, how are you envisioning the future of SandboxAQ at the intersection of science, technology, and innovation for tomorrow?
Well, gee, this is really a moment of great inflection for humanity. This is a moment where our society, our economy, is going to a new place. Right now, the GDP of the United States is about $27, $28 trillion. Worldwide GDP is about $105 trillion. We believe very strongly that the productivity that you can get from large language models, plus the big step function change you can get with LQMs, large quantitative models, the two combined can lead to greater GDP growth for America than we've ever seen in the past. We're used to kind of 1, 2, 3% GDP growth. We think we can get beyond that in the coming years using this combination of large language models and large quantitative models. LLMs get you the productivity on customer service, on document processing, workflow, all that great productivity. That's a big positive. But then LQMs come along and give you the billions of dollars of value creation, creating new kinds of products across the energy sector, the chemical sector, the financial sector, the biopharma sector. 80% of the economy can use LQMs to drive billions of dollars of value per company. So this is a really exciting moment, JD, and we're excited to be the global pace setter in this area.
I gotta say, I feel like I got so much smarter over the course of the last 5 minutes talking with you. Really grateful for your time. Jack, congratulations on all the success at Sandbox AQ, and best of luck for the path ahead.
Thanks, JD.